You are considering purchasing Escape from Tarkov, but you don't really know enough about it yet. The goal of this video is to help you determine whether or not Escape from Tarkov is right for you. So what is Escape from Tarkov? It's a PC-only first-person shooter game developed by Russian-owned Battlestate Games. Tarkov really distinguishes itself with the amount of realistic gameplay, items, weapons, attachments, and considerations you need to make while playing. While of course there are aspects that aren't realistic, Battlestate Games has been quoted on saying that they try to make this game as realistic as playable with its immersive gameplay. While its main genre may be considered first-person shooter, it has aspects of MMO, RPG, survival games, and Battle Royale all combined into one game. So let's get into the specifics. First, I'll describe the setting. Tarkov is the largest city in the fictional Norvinsk region. Located in between Russia and Eastern Europe, it was a gateway to the West. Known originally for having a progressive capitalist economy, it was home to one of the largest and most corrupt group of companies, the Terror Group. After a series of government scandals and investigations gone awry, Terror Group mercenaries, known as USEC, conflicts with an alleged Russian military unit, known as Bear. The conflict between USEC and Bear catapulted the region into chaos, and Tarkov was sealed off from the outside world, with various groups fighting for control. Not all civilians fled Tarkov before it was sealed off from the outside world. Some were stranded and some chose to stay behind for one reason or another. They have found themselves caught in between the two private military contractors fighting for scraps to survive. Eventually, they seem to rally around the regional military warlords, also known as bosses. This group of civilians are known as scavengers, or scavs for short. Scavs and scav bosses are two of the main NPC characters that you'll encounter when you play this game. Along with these two, there are currently two other factions. Raiders, who are former PMCs that have gone AWOL, and Cultists, a creepy but powerful faction we don't know much about. Matches in Tarkov are called raids. These are time matches that are 50 minutes or less, but the actual time depends on the map that you choose. They end when you either die, when the timer runs out, or when you get to an extraction point. As a player of Tarkov, you must choose your private military contractor faction, Bear or USEC. These contractors, known as PMCs for short, are your primary character. When playing as a PMC, you need to equip them with everything that they may need before entering a raid. This is also called their loadout. Along with playing as your PMC character, you have the ability to play as a scav. You will take over an NPC body in an active raid, and you are provided a random loadout. Regardless of who you choose to enter the raid as, the main goal of the game is to survive. As a PMC, your only allies are your friends in your party that you enter the raid with. As a scav, there's incentive to being friendly to other scavs. If you're considered friendly, they will be your allies, helping you to survive and fight PMCs. If you are hostile, however, they will group up and treat you as if you are PMC yourself. The gameplay itself is pretty basic in concept. Choose who you'd like to play as, a scav or a PMC. If you're a PMC, gear up by choosing weapons, ammo, medkits, food, drinks, etc. You will choose a time, head into a raid, loot stuff, kill other characters, if you're a PMC, complete quests, and escape the map before you get yourself killed or find yourself missing in action. Escaping a raid in Tarkov is called extraction. Every time you enter a raid, you may have different extraction points that you're allowed to use. Double tap O to see what they are. Once you extract, you get to keep whatever is on your character, and you get to go chill in your hideout. Sounds easy enough, right? Let's get into the complexity, which is what makes this game so special and incredibly fun. And quite addicting. Just ask my girlfriend. Unlike a lot of popular MMOs and battle royales, in Tarkov, you're constantly working to improve your characters. Both your PMC and your stat character have their own separate progress. Your PMC is your main character that you're always working to improve. You have quests to complete, a hideout to upgrade, skills to progress, etc. When you start a raid, you're essentially dropped onto a random location on the map of your choosing.
I can't believe Command is up and left us here.
If you die, everything that you started with is lost, except for the items that you choose to put in your secure container. However, all may not be lost. For a price, you can purchase insurance on most of your gear. Any scraps remaining after other PMCs and scavengers get to it will be returned to you the next day. You only know the names of where you have to go, but you don't know where they are in relation to everything else if you haven't played the game before. That's right. There's no map that shows where you are in relation to other things, like almost every other game. You can purchase a map from the traders, but it isn't going to really help you much if you don't know where you are. Thankfully, there's some outside help. And if you want to know which direction you're going in, you better bring your compass into the raid. And you don't have those as scabs. You will have to eat, drink, dress wounds, kill other players, loot stuff, and generally just fight to survive while doing other quests. And if you're going into a raid with friends, don't accidentally shoot them. Your friends don't look any different from any other PMCs or the scavs that are hanging around waiting for you to make a mistake.
Ow, ow, ow.
Is that you?
Yes.
I thought you were in the building with me.
If you extract successfully, you can sell the stuff that you looted to a set of traders in exchange for different currencies. If you're a high enough level, then you'll be able to sell goods to other players on something called the flea market, an in-game goods exchange. As you level, you will get the ability to get more things for your hideout, attain more places to put stuff, have better attributes for your character, and be able to get better gear. As a PMC, you'll also be able to build realistic weapons from scratch, customizing whatever aspect you want. You'll learn a surprising amount about real guns and their component parts. Tarkov is strictly a multiplayer game, although it allows you to practice offline with whatever gear your multiplayer account has. About twice a year, Battlestate Games drops a basket of new features, and this should continue until the full game is released. When this happens, all players' progress is reset, or wiped, as if you had just bought the game. This results in a level playing field for everyone. This has been the same pattern since Tarkov started its beta in July 2017. Once the game officially launches, there will be seasons like this, but there will also be a separate persistent game mode where your progress never goes away. Escape from Tarkov is one of the most challenging games that you will ever play. There is a huge learning curve. That's one of the reasons I like it. There are no player icons, no indication of kills in the game, and no indication of distance. This is not your typical run-em-gun-em shooter. There's a real sense of loss when you die, and it can even feel like a horror movie at times. If you're deciding whether or not to buy this game, you need to be willing to learn a lot, as you aren't provided a lot of information when you start the game. If the concept of packing your own magazines while in raid, dying of starvation, bleeding to death, having weapons jam on you in combat, or having to worry about every single item that you take into a raid before you go into it seems like too much effort, then this game might not be for you. If this kind of realistic gameplay sounds intriguing, then give it a try. There are rarely sales, and the game never gets to be more than around 25% off, so I suggest starting with a basic account, as you can always upgrade later if you get hooked on the game. If you choose to take the plunge, I strongly encourage new players to get more familiar with the game by watching videos, studying maps created by the community, and checking out general information on many wikis out there. I'm also planning to release my own series of videos for beginners to help you get started. So smash that like button and subscribe so you can follow along. And as always, I will see you in Tarkov.